Hi children, today we are starting a lesson weight and volume from maths, weight and volume for 5th standard. Okay, we have to learn some basics, that is the measurements. We know that 1 kg is equal to 1000 grams. 1 kg is equal to 1000 grams. Half kg, if you buy half kg of sugar, they will measure as 500 grams. 3 by 4 kg, that is equal to 750 grams. 1 by 4, that is quarter of this 1000 grams, that is 250 grams. You know that next measurements, after 1 kg is 1 quintal. 1 quintal is equal to 100 kg. 1 ton is equal to 1000 kg. These are the basic measurements. So here we are discussing about the conversion of grams to milligrams. So the gram is a greater measurement, it is converted to the smaller measurement, milligram. Okay, we know that 1 gram is equal to 1000 milligram. 1 gram is equal to 1000 milligram. For the conversion of 1 milligram is equal to 1 by 1000 gram. Then, for example, if you get 500 milligram, usually the small things, it may be a gold, silver like that, it can be measured by milligrams. So the larger things, the quantity is greater. So if you buy a half kg, so that is measured in terms of grams. For this minute and gold and silver, it can be measured in terms of milligram and then gram only. Okay children, so here 500 milligram is converted to gram. For that, write down 500 divided by 1000. Here simply, we can simplify this one. 2020 gets cancelled. 5 1s are 5, 5 2s are 10. Answer is 1 by 2. Then it is converted into decimal fact, or otherwise write down as it is 1 by 2 gram, or it can be written in the decimal fact, 1 divided by 2. Children, we know that the decimal fractions, here it is not possible because 2 is, 1 is smaller than this 2. Write 0 and point in the quotient place. We get 0 in the dividend place. The number 1 becomes 10. 2 5 is a 10. Remainder is 0. Answer is 0.2 gram. 0.2 gram. So like that, we have to convert the gram to milligram. And then for the conversion of milligram to gram, also we can learn in the next main. Okay. Now we have to discuss about exercise number 6.1. 6.1. Arthur buys 16 kg of jaggery and 15 kg of rice from a shop. He puts both the pocket into a bag. What is the total weight of the bag? So for that we have to calculate the total quantity of jaggery and rice. Okay. From the exercise number 6.1. Jaggery, how much is it? Jaggery, exercise number 6.1. Jaggery is 16 kg and rice is equal to 15 kg. Now if we add both the jaggery and rice quantities, we get the total weight in the bag. 6 plus 5, 11. 1 carry, 1 plus 1, 2, 2 plus 1, 3 kg. The total weight in the bag is 31 kg. Okay. Next question. Next one. A bag can hold 20 kg of rice. If 145 kg of rice is to be filled equally, how many such bags are required? A bag has capacity of 20 kg of rice to filling in this bag, but we have to calculate for how many bags are needed. complete the 140 kg of rice. For that, we have to do what? 140 divided by 20. The capacity to fill a bag is 20 kg. How many bags are needed to fill this 140 kg of rice? Here 1010 gets cancelled. 2 ones are 27. The answer is 2 bags are needed to fill this 140 kg of rice. Okay. 7 bags are needed to fill 140 kg of rice. Okay. Next one, convert the following. For that, you have to fill in your textbook using your pencil. 7 kg is equal to how much in the 700 grams. I will write one by one. 7 kg is equal to 7,000 grams. We know that 1 kg is equal to 1,000 grams. No? 7 kg is equal to 7,000 grams. 16 grams is equal to 6. How many milligrams? ml. The short form of milligram is ml. Mg. Milliliter is ml. Mg is milligram. So write down 3 zeros, you get the milligram. Because 1 gram is equal to how much? 1 gram is equal to 1000 mg. Mg means milligram. Next one, 6000 gram is equal to dash kg. 1000 gram is equal to 1 kg, you know that. So here 6000 gram is equal to 6 kg. Next one, 750 milligram is equal to dash gram, 7.5. And then 12 quintal is equal to 1200 kg. We know that 1 quintal is equal to 1000 kg. For 12 quintal, 12 into 100, you get 1200 kg. And then 1500 kg is equal to dash quintal. How many quintals? 1 quintal is equal to 1000 kg. For 1500 kg is equal to 15 quintal. Here 15 into 100, you get 1500. Add the following. The next main from exercise number 6.1 is add the following weights. First one, 4 kg, 250 grams, and 12 kg, 355 grams. Write down spaciously, clearly. 4 kg, write down kg and gram. Below that, you have to write neatly 4, 250 gram, 4 kg, 250 gram. Add 12 to the kg. Write down in the correct place, 2 in the unit place, 1 in the tens place, and then write 355. Add both, we get 0 plus 5, 5. 5 plus 5, 10, 1 carry, 1 plus 2, 3, 3 plus 3, 6, and then 4 plus 2, 6, 1. Answer is 16 kg, 605 grams. Okay, one more sum. Second one, 12 kg, 450 gram, 15 kg, and 550 gram. Write down carefully. First one, 12 kg and gram. 12 kg, 450 grams. Next one, they are given only kg, in terms of kg. Write down below 12, 15 write down, and there is no grams they are given. Write down zeros. Here I will write 0 to avoid confusion while adding or subtraction. 550 grams. The next one, there is no kg, and then here 550 grams, write in the gram place. So if they are not given any number to kg or grams, you have to write 0. Okay, children. Next, add this one, you get, write the plus symbol 0. 5 plus 5, 10, 1 carry. 1 plus 4, 5. 5 plus 5, again 10. Again here, 1 carry. 1 plus 2, 3. 3 plus 5, 8. 1, 2. 1 plus 1, 2. Answer is 28 kg. That's all. Okay, children, like that you have to add the given quantities. Add the given weights. Next mean, subtraction. First one, gram from 28 kg 550 gram. So see here, which is the minuend? The bigger number should be right in the minuend place, that is 28 550 grams minus 13 kg 250 gram. Here do the difference. Difference means subtraction. 0 minus 0, 0. 5 minus 5, 0. 5 minus 2, 3. 8 minus 3, 5. 2 minus 1, 1. Answer is 15 kg, 300 gram. Next one. Second one. 55 kg. 335 grams from 85 kg 730 gram. Write down kg and gram. Here which is a minuend, children? The bigger number should be minuend. Write down 85 750 gram minus 55 335 gram. Now we have to do the subtraction. 0 minus 5 is not possible. Take borrow from the nearest one. This number becomes 2. And then this number becomes 10. 10 minus 5, 5. Here also not possible. Take borrow from the 7. The 7 becomes 6. This 12, 2 becomes 12. 12 minus 3, 9. 6 minus 3, 3. 5 minus 0. 5 minus 5, 0. 8 minus 5, 3. Answer is 30 kg, 395 grams. Here is the statement, sir. Radha buys 2 kg, 500 gram of carrot and 2 kg, 500 gram of brinjal and 3 kg, 250 gram of tomatoes from a vegetable shop. So find the total weight of vegetables bought by her. Okay, we know the measurements, children, one more time. 1 gram is equal to 1000 milligram, 1 kg is equal to 1000 gram, half kg is equal to 500 gram, 3 by 4 kg is equal to 750 gram, 1 by 4 kg is equal to 250 gram, 1 ton is equal to 1000 kg, 1 quintal is equal to 100 kg. Now do the statement sum. First one, the quantity of carrot, okay, or weight of the carrot. Weight of carrot. How much? Write down kg and grams. 2 kg, 500 grams. Next, weight of brinjal. Brinjal, again 2 kg, 500 gram. Weight of tomatoes, that is 3 kg, 250 gram. Now we have to add these, we get the total weight of vegetables. Total weight of vegetables. Here 0 plus 0, 0. 0 plus 5, 5. 5 plus 5, 10. 10 plus 2, 12. Further try to 2 and 1 carry. 1 plus 2, 3. 3 plus 2, 5. 5 plus 3, 8. Answer is 5 kg, 250 gram. Next, the yield of a paddy per acre is 29 quintal. The crop yield of a paddy per acre means for 1 acre is 29 quintal and 50 kg, 29 quintal and 50 kg of if the yield of paddy for 30 acres of field, so we have to calculate for the total yield of the paddy in 30 acres. So for 1 acre, that is the yield is 29 quintal, 50 kg. So we have to calculate for how much? 30 acres. What we have to do now? So for the 29 quintal and 50 kg into 30. 30 means what? For 30 acres we have to calculate. For 1 acre, the yield of paddy for 1 acre, that is 29 quintal 50 kg. So for 30 acres, so for that we have to multiplication 29.50, 29 quintal 50 kg into 30. Okay, we know that any number multiplied by 0, we get 0 only. Here 0 is there, 0 minus 0 into 0, 0 into 5, 0, like that we get 0 only. And then leave one place, 3 zeros are 0, 3 5s are 15, 5, 1 carry, 3 9s are 27 plus 1, 28, again 2 carry, 3 2s are 6 plus 2, 8, answer, write down total, 0, 5, 8, 8, write down point after 2 digits, we get the answer, how much? 885 quintal of paddy they were grown in the which place? Paddy, in the field of paddy. Children, next question. 18 kg 400 gram of sugar is to be packed in 4 bags. 18 kg 400 gram of sugar is packed in 4 bags equally. What is the weight of each bag? The total quantity of sugar is 18 kg 400 gram. It is equally divided into 4 bags. Okay. Number of bags is 4. So now the weight of each bag. Weight of each bag is 18 comes out only in grams. So 18, 400. So divided by 4. 4 3s are 12. 4 4s are 16. 4 4s are 16. Remainder 2. Take 4 down. The number becomes 24. 4 6s are 24. Okay, and take 0 down, it is not possible. 4 zeros are 0, and then again take 1 more 0, it also becomes 0. 4 zeros are 0, answer becomes 4600 kg, that is grams, are divided into 4 equal bags. Okay, 4 kg, here we can divide into this one. 4 kg 600 grams. Okay. The total quantity of a liquid containing a vessel is called its volume. Usually volumes are we can measure by the decameters, hectoliters, kiloliters. So usually the standard unit of volume is liter. The standard unit of liter is liter, and then the smaller unit, that is milliliter, is ml, and also kiloliter is kl. The symbol of liter is L. Okay. So 1 liter is equal to 1000 milliliter. 1 liter is equal to 1000 milliliter. 1/2 liter, half liter is equal to 500 ml. So if you buy half liter milk, the measurement, the amount, the quantity is 500 milliliter. 1/4 liter is equal to 250 milliliter, and then 1 kiloliter is equal to 1000 liter. Okay, 1 kiloliter is equal to 1000 kiloliter. From exercise number 6.2, answer it orally. Convert the following liter to milliliter. Children, we know the formula. 5 liter is equal to how much? 5 liter is equal to dash ml, dash milliliter. We know that 1 liter is equal to 1000 milliliter. For 5 liter, we can write it as 500 milliliter. Second one, 1 kiloliter is equal to 6000 liter. Next, 500 ml is equal to 500 ml, milliliter is equal to half liter. Next, 8000 liter is equal to 8000 liter is equal to 8 kiloliter. Next, main, add the following. Add first one, 3 liter 500 milliliter, 750 milliliter, and 6 liter 500 milliliter. Write down 1 by 1 terms of liter and milliliter. 3 liter 500 milliliter. Here, no, they are not given liters. Write down 0 in the liter place, 750 in the milliliter place. 750, and then here 6 liter 500 milliliter. Now we have to add, we get 0 plus 0, 0, 5 plus 0, 5, 5 plus 7, 12, 12 plus 5, 17, 1 carry, 1 plus 3, 4, 4 plus 6, 10. Answer, 10 liter 750 milliliter. Okay, next one, subtract the following. Subtraction. First one, 15 liter 750 milliliter from 25 liter 350 milliliter. Here, which is a minor? 25 liter 350 milliliter is the minor. Minus, subtrahend is 15 liter 750 milliliter. Okay, 0 minus 0, 0, 5 minus 5, 0, 3 minus 7, it is not possible. Take borrow from the nearest one. This 5 becomes 4, this 3 becomes 13. 13 minus 7, 6, 4 minus 5, it is not possible. Take borrow from the next nearest place. This 4 becomes 14. 14 minus 5, 9, 1 minus 1, 0. Answer is 9 liter 600 milliliter. Next one, second one, 34 kiloliter. The short form of kiloliter is KL. 750 liter from 55 kiloliter. Children, carefully write down. First one, in terms of kiloliter and liter, write down 55 liter 00 minus 34 kiloliter 750 liter. Now we have to do the subtraction. 0 minus 0, 0. 0 minus 5 is not possible. Take borrow from the nearest place, but this becomes also 0. Take borrow from the next in the 1000 place. This 5 becomes 4. This 0 becomes 9 because we are already given the borrow to the next place. 10 minus 5, 5. 9 minus 2. 9 minus 7, 2. 4 minus 4, 0. 5 minus 3, 2. Answer is 20 kiloliter 250 liter. Statement sum. Solve the following. Veena buys 3 liter 250 milliliter of groundnut oil. Veena buys 3 liter 250 milliliter of groundnut oil. And while returning from her office, her mother also bought 1 liter 500 milliliter of groundnut oil on the same day. What is the total quantity of groundnut oil bought by them? So Veena buys oil, that is groundnut oil. How many liters? 3 liters, 250. Milliliters. But our mother also buys some groundnut oil, that is 1 liter 500 milliliter. So we have to calculate the total quantity of groundnut oil bought by them, by Veena, and then her mother. 0 plus 0, 0. 5 plus 0, 5. 2 plus 5, 7, 4, 3 plus 1, 4, answer 4 liter 750 milliliter. So both of them bought 4 liter 750 milliliter of groundnut oil. Next one, a bottle contains 1 liter 500 milliliter of sandal oil. It has to be filled into the bottles. 250 milliliter. Usually the liquids are measured in terms of liters. Okay children, how many bottles are required? Second one, quantity of sandal oil, that is equal to 1 liter 500 milliliter. It has to be filled 250 milliliters. So here we have to calculate how many bottles are required to fill this 1 liter 500 milliliter. Okay, for that this becomes 1500. For converting 1 liter to milliliter, 1 liter is equal to 1000 milliliter. That 1000 plus 500 becomes 1500 divided by 250. Okay, 256 are 1500. So how many bottles are required to fill? 6 bottles are required to fill 1 liter 500 ml of sandal oil. Okay, for 2 ml of bottle each. So this is about a weight and volume. So after the class was completed, so you have to draw or paste the gram and kilogram and then milliliter and liter in the last page.